not that much difficult or complex as people are thinking, but it's quite interesting. First, how to understand this story is the first thing is that we must know the way how to understand this story. Most of the students, what do? They do not bother to take out the vocabulary. What they do think is that this is the means time consuming. Of course, it is time consuming, but do not take. If you think that this is time consuming, do not take hold of the vocabulary. Just take very few words that are the main words in the story. The main words are most probably they are emphasized more, and they are used more, and yes, the main words will be used more and more. You will be bothered by them, and you will not get. Finally, you will not get the story. Understand?
So let us discuss the word that is skip. You might have gone through the story, and this word you might have found. This word is used most in the story. It means a boat, a little boat.
Little boat.
Sailed by one person, like you see. And another word like this sail. You might have found this word. This sail means.
Sail means.
A journey. In a sea. All right. Another word that we are going to write is harpoon. The word is harpoon.
Harpoon.
That is a long spear. Spear. Used to
catching large fish.
Catching fishes. Catching fish. And another is you may say you might have found word. Or, O-A-R, or. This is a wooden stick used to move a board. And then there is a word you might have found, gaff. The word is gaff, G-A-F-F. This means, this, yeah. This is a hook. Iron hook, this is an iron hook which is used to kill fish. Kill or beat the fishes, like you may say. And then there is carcass. Carcass actually is a dead body of any animal. Simply, we have the word shake. This, the word shake is actually a little hurt. And then there is the word bed. Bed means, it's an A. Bed means we place food in a net.
Go.
Fish. Bed means we place food in a net to catch the fish. Simply. Actually, I found this in PDF. There are approximately 35 words which are main vocabulary of this novel, but very few I have pointed out in front of you. These will help you to understand what the story tells us about. And these, most probably these words will come and these will bother you in reading the story. And if you come across, if you know the meaning of these words, you may be able to know the story very well. Now let us discuss about the main characters of this story. The main character, or you may say, as we say, the hero of this story is Santiago. Santiago is the hero, or you may say the interesting character and the main character of this story. Actually, there are three main characters. This you may say the hero, like a hero. And another character that is main is Manolin. Then there is another character that is main is Marlin. After that, there are two characters. There are two characters which did not appear in the story, but they are mentioned. First one is Joy DeMaggio. And the second character that did not appear in the story, but it is mentioned, that is Paik. And then you might be confused in Paik, and there is another character, that is Patrick. You might be confusing these, both of these. I will just clarify them, that what is, you may say, I will differentiate them, that what is the difference between these two characters. And then there is another character, that is these two characters did not appear in the novel. Did not appear. Just their names are mentioned, and further these are three main characters in the novel that are mentioned. Then there is your Marcus Sharp. Let me have a little introduction on these characters that I have pointed out. This is Santiago, an old man. The hero of this story, he is an old, and his skin is totally wrinkled. And there are blotches on his face that are by the sunshine of the sun. And then there is Manolin. He is the friend. Friend and student of Santiago. Santiago is a lonely person who does not have anyone to share the ideas with. But Manolin is the person, is the boy who shares everything with the Santiago, who discusses everything, and he supports Santiago a lot. And they are friend as well, and Manolin is also the student of Santiago. Santiago teaches him how to fish. When Manolin was 5 years, Santiago taught him how to fish. Since then, he was along with Santiago, but because of bad luck of Santiago, that story further I will tell you in the story. Now let us come to a sketch of Marlin. Actually, Marlin is a fish. Marlin is a fish which is directly connected to the Santiago. What happens is complete. The story that is interesting, that there is an interesting part in the story, that is the dispute. Complete story depends upon the dispute of this Marlin and Santiago. That is the interesting and interesting part of the story, and that the story is based on the dispute. There is dispute between them, or you may say duel between them. Santiago tries to, you may say, catch this Marlin. Marlin is a big fish. Its size is actually 18 feet. It is 18 feet long, or you may say 5.5 meters long fish. Now let us come to this Joy DeMaggio. This does not appear in the story, but actually Joy DeMaggio is best baseball player. He is a baseball player whom Santiago likes most, and he's a favorite player of Santiago. Then there is, I told you that I will tell you the difference between Paik and Patrick. This is Patrick, P-E-D-R-I-C, and this is Paik. This also does not appear in the story, but he provides newspaper. He provides newspaper to Santiago. And this is Paik. Paik is actually, he appears in the story. What he does, he measures the size of this marlin, this fish. He measures its, you may say, size, and as well as Patrick is given head of the fish when it comes to, you may say, shore, beach shore. And what happens, this Patrick looks after old man's skiff or gear. I might not have discussed the word gear. This means the gear is for means through which or by which